Good afternoon. Yeah, it's a pleasure for me to introduce to you the Jacquard project. It's a project that started this year. A cooperation between the Dutch Center of Mathematics and Computer Science, PricewaterhouseCoopers, the Dutch Tax Office, and my company, ComputationalAuditing.com. I started that company 7 years ago and started in the Netherlands and now in Canada. I'm 5 years in Canada now. And before that, I was 15 years at Deloitte as a principal, as chief architect of an inventor of smart audit support, to work with Trevor. Early days developing the system, designing the system. And since 1994, it's key in Deloitte's international worldwide audit practice. And the system blueprint is in my PhD thesis, and I did it at the same time parallel to that project at Deloitte. And that's a PhD in mathematics and computer science. The microphone, yeah, sorry. It's a PhD in mathematics and computer science on financial auditing. Okay, this microphone is not working. Okay. Not this one? Okay. So the Jacquard project is focusing on building a domain-specific language, a DSL, to capture concepts and methods of the owner-audit audit tradition. There are two audit traditions, actually, the management-audit audit tradition and the owner-audit audit tradition. And, first I will introduce the audit domain challenge and then position the audit the owner-audit audit approach, relating it to that domain challenge, and then introduce the Jacquard project from there. Today's audit challenge from the IFAC. The intention here is to highlight shareholder control, long-term shareholder control. There should be a more emphasis in that direction. And this is published on the website of the IFAC. All this is from the summer this year, and there's also in the European Commission also notice focuses on the same point. So there's a consensus of on this type of direction. And then this is the focus on the audit, every individual audit. And the second challenge is relating that micro role of the auditor to a macro level, so the systemic risk anticipating on systemic risk for financial institutions, but also for other corporations. And Jules Muis has contributed to that, also on the IFAC. the point is especially to increase the relevancy of the audit contribution. So, relating that to Douglas Carmichael's statement for the PCAOB, so the most important factor is society needs, and then find the audit methods that can serve these needs in society. And that's the way to move forward, from Limberg. And then the owner audit audit approach, that's actually what's started in the Netherlands and the UK. And relating that to what's happened in the USA. So if you go back in time, 170 years, and at the time when the railroads were built in the United States, that point in time more or less, then the audit profession came into existence by market mechanisms. In the US, it was just to increase creditability, or to attract money from Great Britain. The money was there in Great Britain, most of the money. And the intention was to increase credibility of the statements of management to attract investors from Great Britain, so to maximize the equity. And and the direction of the audit was, is it not overstated? Are the profits not overstated? Is the equity not overstated? And on the other hand, on the same time, you had in the UK and the Netherlands, you had these investors there, and they had, of course, the opposite interest. And if it's not understated, do we get all the profits? Is it made visible, all these profits, since it's related to their dividends, to what they will share in these profits? So that's another direction on the revenues and the profit. Are no revenues missing? Is it not understated? Is it not, or even unstated? How to find something that's not stated? So that's a different audit method is behind that tradition. So after 1930, it more or less, we get branching scientific approaches. Lindbergh was not very charmed by ethics, so he wanted rational expectations. That's his theory. So 1926, and he lived till 1961. So these decades, the whole tradition and all the education of the generations of auditors was all geared towards rational expectations, rational methods. And the core of that rational method, the foundation of it, is what I call a super cycle, the waardekringloop, the value cycle, top cycle of the business. So you have there the purchase, the buy side, and the sell side, and they are connected with a process structure. There's a process structure, all these things are related. And this is actually the foundation from the Dutch auditing doctrine, and it's actually originated by Smalenbach in 1929, and it evaluated over the time. And, well, it was of course originally a conceptual model, but nowadays we can also interpret this type of diagrams as a process specification, as a process model, and do some analysis on it. So it's not only a bundle of pixels anymore, it's also a specification, a diagram, a model that a computer can understand and analyze. And so you get some support in how to analyze such a process structure. So if we address today's challenge number one, why ignore the proven method of the owner audit? It's out there for several decades, but unfortunately it's only available in Dutch. There are only two translations into English, very short. One is by Hans Blokdijk and one is by myself, chapter two of my PhD. So there was no effort by the Dutch made to translate it into English. That's a pity. But the method is there, it's a proven method, but it's hardly used anymore. So it's the idea is to take that method and bring it back again, and also relating to the second challenge. And then the whole idea behind it is then to relate to the second challenge is the reliability of the information, and it's based on long-term incentives. So there should be a long-term authorization and incentive structure. Since if the whole audit tradition from the Netherlands, since it's an owner-ordered audit and directed towards things that are not stated, unstated information, you need some kind of model with expectations, normative model, to find the relationship between the volumes on the buy side and the sell side and bring them into relation to the generated profit. So if there's a volume of 100 sales and 100 purchases, there's a normative relation in the amount of profit that should be created by by that volume of business transactions. And if that amount of profit is not there, then, well, you need some explanation for that. So something is missing. That's the way to find something, that something is missing in the... And the so if you have that super cycle thing, that model, then there are two mainstays on top of that foundation. One is that you need irreplaceable internal controls, since you need a very strong concept of internal control that is irreplaceable. And so the notion of segregation of duties and long-term incentives from the owner perspective, long-term ownership. So you can think, for example, as a franchisor and a franchisee. So the franchisor wants all his franchisees that he sees all the profit. When it's a hotel chain or a restaurant chain or a retail chain, the franchisor wants to see all the profits. And are these hotels, the management, operational management in these hotels, are they not making profit with these rooms, renting them out, and not sharing it with the franchisor? So that's where the owner audit steps in, giving assurance about the completeness of the revenues. And what's needed for that is a strong notion of segregation of duties. That's a very main thing of the irreplaceable internal control. And the other mainstay is the spending reconciliation checks. So we have the super cycle. So there's a strong mathematical relation between the volume of business transactions, buy side, sell side, and profit. So there's a golden opportunity, more or less, for the audit profession. On the pull side, there's the to improve the audit profession's relevancy to society, the both challenges. And on the push side, there's a lot of research and development of supportive concepts and technology nowadays. So the matchmaking between these push and the pull is to internationalize the owner-ordered audit method. The method itself, since this long-term ownership is not there anymore, that long-term ownership, since the things are sold in a different way than it was used to be done, but the method is still there. And that requires deep computational support. And why? Well, to minimize the international educational burden, since the Dutch audit education used to be 3-year post-master, and the master education itself was already 6 years. So it took 9 years to become an auditor in that old-fashioned way of doing the audit. So it was a heavy education. And and also to streamline the trainer and roll out and getting the return on investment fast. So the computational support is necessary therefore. Okay, and then the Jacquard project. the project lead is with the Dutch Center of Mathematics and Computer Science. And the project partner are Price, the tax office, and my company, and we focus on a domain-specific language. And we have make several layers. There will be an open source layer, public domain layer that will be available for everybody. And my company is making available some of our software. We will bring it open. We will make it open source. And on top of that layer, there can be commercial applications just as plugins. That's the idea. And the connection with the Dutch National Center, they have a special language to build languages. So they have a DSL, a domain-specific language, to make domain-specific languages. So it's a bootstrapping thing that we can speed up that whole thing. And it's out there for decades already, so it's a very proven thing. Okay, 5 minutes. Okay, so what's a DSL? Just a domain-specific language. It's a kind of programming language, specification language, but especially it should be graphical. Should be graphical, and we will relate it to the value cycle, the super cycle, the top cycle. And what will it support? Well, on the quantitative side, it's the completeness. On the qualitative side, it's the long-term incentive and authorization structure, and all founded on that super cycle process model. And there's also a huge slide pack with 101 slides, and it's in the in the sixth group. It's the research school on information and knowledge systems in the Netherlands. So yeah, what are the key audit phases in that next generation auditing data assurance as a service? And it's just a focus on just like software as a service. The whole idea is then to have software on the web. You don't have a package of software anymore. The software is running on the web, and you can use that software as a service. That's the whole idea. So there are 5 phases. Super cycle mining, that's the whole idea. You just take an event log from the business and generate a diagram from it, the super cycle, in the East modality, as it is. And then you derive the soul, as it should work from it. And as another source, you can use all audits you already did for that type of industry. So that's your norm, your normative thing. Then you can do your continuous auditing, confront a stream of business events to the soul. And then collect all the deviations, and we can use the Dempster-Shaver-Srivastava method to aggregate all that information. And actually, that whole thing of the super cycle, it's equivalent to a bunch of equations. So it's a bunch of equations with all parameters in there, the sales side volumes, buy side volumes, and the stock and the monies. And all these equations are there relating all these quantities. And then you publish it on a supercycle dashboard. So this is just a picture of the East supercycle mining. So you get to use red arrows that are the wrong things. So to 2,500 times an invoice received without a prior approval, you get it as a diagram. So you just take the event log and generate the diagram. Just a smart flow chart, but not manually created, just automatically. This is already there, process mining. Then you get a continuous auditing. You can confront the business stream. And you can see it on my website. There's a movie just illustrating how it works. Then you generate the equation system from it. It's just equivalent to the diagram. It's just another way of representing it. And then you can relate to the Dempster-Shaver-Srivastava theory. And this gives also the order direction per parameter, overstatement or understatement, in an algebraic relation. It's already proven over decades in the Netherlands, in education, in theory, and in practice. Then you can do your continuation. On the qualitative side, you get it for segregation of duties, intercept authorization change request, and decide what to do with it.
Sorry, Philip, just a couple of minutes for conclusion. Yeah, okay. Thanks.
Aggregating the deviations with XBRL. So we are making the language with XBRL operators. And don't stop the aggregation on the audit individual audit level, but continuing aggregating to the macro level. So then you get the systemic risk indicators from Buchstaber. And you can also use it for sustainability, completeness of revenue, completeness of pollution, and publish an error sheet, and you get these red rings for your internal controls where the weak spots are. And these are some example operators, segregation of duties, bill of material, that's where we're working on. And this is just something from, but that price put in, we are just starting the project. I won't give comment on this, but it's just good, you can have a look at it. It's just done by price. They are using this material and they are working on it to implement it, and they are already are in touch with clients to show this method, and the clients are also very interested in it and very excited about it. So Price is already willing to share it and publish it. So also connecting to SAP systems, tables. And strange, but too, yeah, this is just an example of how the segregation of duty analysis could work. Data allows us to prevent fraud that data won't reveal. These are the invisible situations, the traceless situations, that the segregation of duty is not working properly, so you get these, you know, things. Okay.